Welcome. You're here at Theme Park Mark. Today we're here at the Imperial War Museums over in Duxford. We're checking out the Land Warfare Museum today. It's a first time visit for me. So let's have a look. Let's see what's here. I think we'll start with a little walk along here, shall we? It's an impressive setup. So we've got multiple nationalities here. I just race. US field gun here. We've got the British heavy trench mortar just here. Heavy 6-inch one.
Thank you. Inspected the units he was to command and toured the factories producing arms and equipment for the Second Front. Around Britain, the build-up of men and equipment for the invasion gathered momentum. All the invasion planning had confirmed Normandy as the best landing site, but a deception plan, codenamed Fortitude, was used to convince the Germans that the main invasion would be at Calais, tying up their strategic reserve until the 7th of August. Air attacks cut off northern France by destroying bridges and railways. Meanwhile, increased resistance activity disrupted the Germans' lines of communication. In early June 1944, the weather deteriorated, and D-Day, set for the 5th of June, was postponed. With a brief respite enabled Eisenhower to take the decision to launch the invasion on the 6th of June. He gave the order, "Okay, we'll go." Just after midnight, Allied airborne forces landed to protect both flanks of the invasion site.
Over 156,000 troops and
Thank you.